previously on the Glow Up Diaries.
My skin hurts so much. I'm like crying tears.
So here was my skin April 1st, my skin May 22nd.
Today is day one. I just took my first pill of Accutane ever. No side effects so far. It's been about 5 minutes since I took the pill. I think I'm fine.
Eyebrows, eyeshadow, lips. But I just want to say that right now I'm doing my makeup and as I look in the mirror, I'm not happy with what I see.
I want to tell myself right here to be patient with yourself. Good things take time. I know you're uncomfortable in your own skin right here and you wish things could just get easier overnight, but if that were the case, then you wouldn't have the skills to be your dream self. Everything you are going through is teaching and preparing you for what you've always wanted to be.
The bottom line here is that you can change, but you need to put the action into it. And don't spend your time dwelling saying, oh my gosh, I don't like the way I look. Sure, I'm not that happy with the way I look, but I tell myself, I look in the mirror and I say, Olivia, I am proud of you for making the decision and taking the actions to change yourself for the better. I love you and you're going to be great. All about positive self-talk out loud, people. Let's go.
I've created this 21 days of self-love journal prompt challenge that I will link below in the description if you'd like to try it.
So Jolie just got out of school and she decided to come with me to Sprouts as we shop for some food. A tip that I have is I always like to park further from the store so then it allows me to walk more. You've been in this room too long. Come on, feel the sun on your skin. On your skin. So the question is, how do you know which avocados are good and bad? Okay, so this is like really hard, so obviously it's not ripe. You gotta find one that's like slightly soft, not too mushy.
It's usually the darker one.
So I just got home from the grocery store and I'm like really, really hungry. And I probably have an hour till dinner. And I don't wanna be too hungry at dinner because then I think if you let yourself go too long for being like really hungry, by the time it gets time to when you actually eat, you like eat a ton of food. So I'm actually gonna, I like to space it out a little bit more. I'm thinking I'm gonna have some of my raspberries and maybe a little bit of the popcorn.
Let me treasure you.
See, this is why it's important to have good, healthy snacks at hand. So then like, you know, you can resort to this. Also, make sure you get rid of all your unhealthy snacks in your cabinets, because if you don't, you're going to end up eating them. Like, don't even feel bad for throwing, guys, don't even feel bad for throwing away. Oh, I had such a healthy influence on JoJo. What did I do? I forgot. I encouraged JoJo to bring Skinny Pop to lunch instead of Ruffles, and she's actually going to do that. So
here's my healthy snack of the day: 5 raspberries and half a cup of Skinny Pop and some water. Although I really want to get into like teas, so I'm gonna have to go scavengering for that.
On today's menu, I'll be teaching you how to make a low-calorie vegan pizza in 6 minutes. You will need marinara sauce. I highly recommend this one in specific because I have tried other sauces and they tasted terrible and it ruined the whole pizza. You will also need pita bread. I usually use this organic whole wheat one, and any vegetable toppings of your choice. First, you're going to preheat the oven to 425 degrees Fahrenheit and then spread a little oil on your pan so your pita bread doesn't stick. Then spread the sauce on your pita bread. Place any toppings of your choice on there, stick it in the oven for 6 minutes, and voila, lunch is served.
So I just finished piano class, and I have piano at 11:45 in the morning. You know, I knew that when I finish, it would be lunchtime. So I came prepared. I'm actually planning to go shop a little bit. I'm in Pasadena, if you're wondering. Always be prepared with like food if you know you're gonna be out during lunchtime or something like that. Because when you get too hungry, I've noticed when I get too hungry, when I go eat something, I just binge. Like, I don't even care if it's like I just want food, you know? So just always be prepared with like healthy alternatives and snacks and things like that. Time to drive, but music on.
Here's the thing, guys. I haven't started shopping for my dorm yet, and I move out in less than a month. So let's start now. The theme for it is lavender with a mix of warm colors, like light orangish hues, kind of like a sunset. I'm going for the boho vibe, so dream catchers, moons, suns, things like that. Oh, I'm gonna get some fairy lights.
Yes. You say no. Maybe.
Wow, it's actually orange inside. That's a little misleading. This would be kind of cute, right? Do you see it?
No. Nope. Too expensive, so no. Yes, yes, yes!
You guys know I'm doing a whole wardrobe transformation. Here's the backstory to it. When I was younger, my mom bought all my clothes. Obviously, because I didn't make any money. And her rule was that she had to like the clothing. Now, my mom has great style, don't get me wrong. But it's not my style. It's not me. So now, I'm shopping for clothing that's so me. An urban home for my dorm, so I'm just gonna go online. There's so much more online anyway. As for the clothing, I think I want to wait a little bit because I can't just treat myself when I haven't done much work, you know? Like, treats are to be earned, so I need to lose a little weight. I'm gonna use buying certain pieces of clothing as incentives for me to lose weight. And it doesn't always need to be that. It could be like treating yourself to go getting your nails done. I'm gonna actually go get my hair done later, not today. Maybe like next week.
So traffic was really bad on the way home, and I needed something quick and easy with all the ingredients prepared for me to make. And this is where I wish I had known about HelloFresh. If you don't want to worry about grocery shopping every week, I highly recommend HelloFresh, a food delivery service company that delivers to your doorstep weekly, and you can manage your delivery dates to match your ever-changing schedule. My family actually uses HelloFresh because of their fresh ingredients and quick mealtime prep, so it's really cool actually that I'm getting to work with them. I think it is a great transition for anyone who wants to get their family to start eating healthier, as there is a family meal plan option. There's also a meat and vegetarian one as well.
This is great because it has all the ingredients. You don't have to shop for it.
I don't really eat meat, but I did order the meat version specifically for Susu because she heard HelloFresh was working with me again. She's like, oh my gosh, give me more HelloFresh. The only reason I didn't get some for myself is because I'm in college and I don't have a kitchen.
You guys can get started with 6 meals free. That's 2 free meals on your first 3 HelloFresh boxes. Just go to HelloFresh.com and enter Olivia60 for a total of $60 off.
America's best volume meal plan starting at $6.99 per serving. The ingredients are kind of fun, kind of fresh, kind of good.
Right now.
Hi guys.
Should I film the studio?
I am shook. Honestly,
do you follow me?
So
okay, these are subscribers. Like, I show up to dance class and all these subscribers show up.
Hey. I thought I was the only one who.
Are you serious? That's so funny. Yeah.
Hi Nikolai. Hi Eva. Yes, so I do know her.
Does it get easier?
Yes. It gets easier. The more you know who you are.
I love oaty things, so I'm going to show you how to make these vegan oat bars. For dry ingredients, you will need a cup of rolled oats, a cup of oat flour, a teaspoon of cinnamon, a teaspoon of baking powder, and a quarter teaspoon of salt. For wet ingredients, you will need 2 ripe bananas, half a cup of plant-based milk, and 1 to 2 teaspoons of agave nectar. Preheat the oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit and mix your dry ingredients in a bowl. Then mash your bananas and mix it with the wet ingredients.
Mix the wet and dry mixtures together. And toppings are optional. I added coconut shreds and almonds. Pour your mixture onto a baking sheet, making the bar about 1.5 inches thick. Bake it in the oven for about 18 to 20 minutes, and then your vegan oat bar is ready to be enjoyed.
I can't move.